Good day. Today we're going to take a look at a relatively new brand of LiPo battery, Auline. Specifically, I'm going to compare the Auline 4S 1000mAh 60C Micro FPV drone battery with the GMB 4S 1100mAh LiPo to see how it stacks up. Both of these are lightweight, high-capacity Micro FPV drone batteries, good for extended, endurance, or longer-range flights with your Micro FPV drone. Neither of these, with their C ratings or discharge rates, are designed for high-performance, max-thrust flights. They're more for just cruising around. I'll take a look at the physical characteristics, check internal resistance, and show you the results of my extended flight fly-off between the two. Let's see if the Auline Challenger can actually compete with a well-known GMB champion as a Micro FPV drone battery for extended flight. Remember, if you find this useful, make sure to hit that thumbs up button below and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel, your home for your journey to better FPV fun, flights, and racing stuff. All right, first of all, let's go ahead and take a look at both of their physical dimensions and weights. The Auline 1000 comes in at 64 millimeters long by 38 by 18, whereas the GNB comes in at 59 by about 34 by 25.6. All right, let's weigh them in. The GNB weighs in at 91.2 grams, and the Auline comes in at 83.2 grams. So there's about an 8-gram difference between the Auline and the GNB, Auline being 8 grams lighter.
So based on that, remember last video I showed you on my website, one of the factors I look at before purchasing a battery is its capacity to weight ratio. Here we see that both of these Micro FPV drone batteries are very similar in that regard. So if we can get approximately the same flight time on the Auline that we do with the GNB while saving 8 grams of weight, and both at about the same price point, I may be switching over to the Auline 4S 1000 for my extended flight times with a Micro FPV drone weighing in at 0.55 pounds or less, which is under 250 grams.
All right, let's take a look at their internal resistances. First of all, both of these are brand new batteries. Neither one has ever been used, and this is the first time I'm charging each of them. I'll be using my Hobbymate D6 dual light smart charger. And we can see the time up here that each one of them are charging. So we'll wait just a couple minutes and then we'll check the internal resistance, which will show up down here after I use the scroll wheel. All right, let's take a look at the internal resistance of both of these LiPos. After about 2.5 minutes, on channel 1, our Auline 4S 1000 has an internal resistance of probably about, lowest is 50 on a cell, highest about 65. So I'm going to guess probably around between 55 and 60. And then on our channel 2, our GNB 4S 1100 has a much lower internal resistance of about, I'm going to say around 18. So you can see the IR on the Auline 4S 1000 is higher than that of the GNB 4S 1100. This actually should be a little bit lower since it's got a higher capacity, but I'm not sure it should be that much lower. Now when you measure the IR of your new Micro FPV drone batteries, remember to record it somewhere so that you have it as a reference number for future measurements. You can write it on the LiPo with a Sharpie pen, or as I demonstrated in this video, on the D6 dual light charger. I use a LiPo battery management Excel spreadsheet, which I'll place the template for you to download in the video description below. All right, here we are coming close to the end of the charging cycle, and we'll take a look at the internal resistances again, see if they've changed at all. On the Auline 4S 1000 channel 1,
It looks like they have dropped down to about, I'm guessing around 45 maybe. And on the GNB 4S1100, they're still much lower, probably around 13. So the Auline still does have a higher internal resistance than the GNB. That may say something about the longevity of the Auline over time. We'll just have to see.
Okay, before we go any further, I found it a little bit interesting that the internal resistance of the Auline was that much higher than the GNB. So I went ahead and did some further testing to make sure it wasn't a one-off based on either of these specific batteries. So I tested three more brand new Auline 4S 1000 mAh LiPos and recorded their internal resistances 2 minutes into charging and at charging completion. I didn't have any more new GNB 4S 1100 mAh LiPos to test, so I compared the last new Auline I had with a slightly used GNB using the same charger and methodology. I've recorded all my results in this table, and just to summarize, the results I obtained with this methodology were the Auline 4S 1000 mAh LiPos had an internal resistance between 2 to 3 times greater than the GNB 1100 mAh LiPos. As I mentioned earlier, I'd expect the 1000 mAh Auline's internal resistance to be a bit higher than the GNB's simply because its capacity is lower. However, I have much lower capacity GNB 4S LiPos that also have a lower internal resistance than these Aulines. So what does this mean? Well, honestly, at this point, I don't know. It may indicate we'll get fewer cycles out of the Auline over an extended period of use than we do the GNBs, or perhaps they'll last just as long. Even if they do end up having a shorter lifespan, the question then is, how much shorter? When you're talking about the average lifespan of a LiPo being on the order of a few hundred cycles, possibly lasting 2 to 3 years, perhaps a lifespan that's 10% less, yet the battery weighing 8 grams less, might be worth using it for your Micro FPV drone flight battery. All right, let's go ahead and continue with our testing and check out the Auline's flight time performance against the GNBs, which is what we all should be interested in.
All right, now that we have the capacity to weight ratios, the internal resistances of both batteries, and they've both been fully charged, let's see if the Auline 4S 1000 Micro FPV drone battery can hold its own with respect to the flight time against the GNB 4S 1100 milliamp hour battery. Keep in consideration the Auline at about 83 grams is about 8 grams lighter than the GNB, so that could make a difference with regards to registering your drone and later on requiring remote ID. Of course, this is one flight, and in this video I'm not taking into consideration the lifespan of either of these Micro FPV drone batteries. That's something that we'll have to take a look at over a period of time. Since these are going to be long flights, I'm just going to show you the start and ends. Here we go.
Okay, those were some interesting results. I was not expecting that. I could think of a few more words to describe it. Surprising, shocking, ridiculous, unbelievable. I thought so too. So I redid the exact same test using another brand new Auline against a used GNB. I wish I could tell you I got different outcomes. I did not. I got nearly identical results. Maybe I saved you a few bucks here today. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.